It's been rather a busy week of regional relations and signing of treaties between Uganda and Tanzania in the hope to ease cross-border trade by curbing non-tariff barriers. The private sector summit that happened this week too is, according to the business community, a step in the right direction, especially easing operations. Also, what is next for the skyrocketing fuel prices across Africa? Will the countries have to wait for the end of the Russian war, or is there a possibility that this could actually come to an end? Welcome to the Business Show. Here now are some of the stories making news in the world of business. Uganda Airlines reduces flights to Dubai. Skyrocketing tomato prices worry traders and consumers. FSDU, FSMEs sign MOU to boost financial access to businesses. And Toyota cuts production due to COVID-19 lockdown in Shanghai. Welcome to the Business Show. Now speak to any business person and their biggest challenge will most likely be access to financing, especially to boost their business. This has also been coupled by some of the business people with the behavior of commercial banks that is unfriendly. So how can this be solved? On Views from the Top, Nora Koi-Jingare, the Director Deal Flow Facility, speaks about how there is a new model of financing that allows investors to partner with the business owners in order to facilitate business growth.
Good evening. My name is Nora Koigi-Ngare and I'm the director of the Deal Flow Facility at Financial Sector Deepening Uganda.
Thank you for speaking to us, Nora, on the Business Show. Kindly run us through the Deal Flow Facility and what it seeks to address.
Thank you, Simon. So the Deal Flow Facility is a technical assistance and matchmaking facility. So the why? The Deal Flow Facility was set up to address the issue of access to finance for growing businesses in Uganda. So a study was conducted by the European Union that showed that businesses were struggling to find finance and were lagging behind their counterparts in the wider East Africa region for various reasons. One of them was that investors were not able to find readily investable businesses in Uganda. Another key reason was that enterprises in Uganda were unaware of alternative sources available to them outside of commercial banking. The Deal Flow Facility was set up to address these amongst other challenges. So what it is essentially a facility that is non-investing, meaning we don't have any capital of our own to invest. What we do have is a fund that allows us to provide technical assistance to enterprises to make them investor ready. We then match them with investors. Now, the Deal Flow Facility was set up in concert with Financial Sector Deepening Uganda, the Capital Markets Authority of Uganda, and it's funded by the European Union.
All right, so one would ask then, as a business person, I've been trying to get money from the banks. So what is unique about the Deal Flow Facility? Why don't I stay with the bank and still get financing for my business?
So the DFF is not trying to compete with banking. What we're trying to do is actually complement banking finance. So what this means is that for enterprises that are able and can afford to access banking finance, that's fine. So for the Deal Flow Facility specifically, what we aim to do is target enterprises that are struggling to raise finance. And this could be for various reasons. One, they could have structural issues within their businesses that are making them not attractive to investors. Another reason is that they may not know what's available to them outside of banking finance. So the Deal Flow Facility is not trying to displace commercial banking funding, but actually complementary, because the aim of the Deal Flow Facility is to increase access to finance for enterprises in Uganda. So banks typically provide debt, whereas a lot of businesses in their growth stage really need equity to actually propel them to the next phase of growth. So it is targeted mainly for businesses who've achieved the maximum level of organic growth that they can, meaning that they've bootstrapped, they've raised sources of funding internally, but need that extra boost to get them to the next phase of growth. So this is where alternative sources of capital come in, specifically around private equity.
All right, so after COVID, almost every business person that struggles or struggled wants to hear something about financing to support their businesses. The question is, you are talking about up to a tune of maybe 1.8 billion funding. What are some of the things that these businesses must have to even think about, you know, applying for this facility?
Thank you, Simon. So the deal for facilities criteria for participation is really threefold. One, we are looking for enterprises that are registered and operating in Uganda. Two, we are looking for enterprises that have at least 2 years of audited statements. And this is really just to show that this business has been around for a long time and proof of concept has been achieved, and they're actually a stable business that's a going concern. The last category, the last element of the criteria we look at is that we're looking at businesses that are raising at least $500,000, and this is the equivalent of about 1.8 billion UGX, like you mentioned. And this can be either debt or equity or a combination of the same. It's also important to note that the deal flow facility is sector agnostic, and what this means is that we're willing to support any business in any sector within the Ugandan economy.
Great, so we've heard that so far you have some businesses that you're really working with. Maybe just break down for us the key sectors that have taken up this money or that have come out, and what are some of the unique things you're teaching them or imparting their businesses to stay afloat?
So far we launched four applications in January of this year, and since then we have received about 100 applications. And of these, about 80 of them qualify for the deal flow facility. In terms of what we're seeing in sector trends, the three largest sectors represented so far are agriculture and agribusiness, fintech, and hospitality. And this really speaks to, one, agribusiness and agriculture really being the mainstay of the Ugandan economy. Two, we are seeing a really big emergence of technology, specifically around the financial sector in Uganda. And three, a key element that we've noticed is that the recovery from COVID is actually spurring a lot of hospitality businesses that struggled during the pandemic to actually reboot and raise capitals. So these are the three key areas that we are seeing a lot of interest from.
Yeah. Let's talk a bit about the issue of collateral. So we know that most people or most businesses have lost their property to banks because of, you know, we failed to pay them the loan in the agreed time. Does this facility have a similar arrangement of put here what you have first and then we can give you this money? And then in the event that I am struggling to meet the agreed time of payment, what happens to my business?
Thank you, Simon. I think at this point it's important to reiterate that the deal flow facility does not actually provide investment capital. What we do provide is technical assistance, then link you to investors. So when it comes to technical assistance, one, it's a cost share between the company and the deal flow facility. And the main reason for this is that we require buy-in really from enterprises. And we see that when you pay for something, you're actually invested in this element for, and you're actually willing to see it to fruition. So when it comes to investors, what we see is that when you're working with alternative sources of funding, investors tend to be more flexible to the needs of the business. Case in point is private equity investors. When private equity investors come into a business and actually acquire a stake in the business, they are invested as partial owners in the success of this business. So they tend to do everything possible when a business is in crisis to actually ensure that it survives and recovers. So alternative sources of funding tend to be a lot more flexible when payment crunches come about, for instance, due to the pandemic, compared to commercial banking funding.
All right, just talk to us a bit about how long this project will be working and what target are you looking at? And on that, why do you think the knowledge about capital markets facility or anything in that line hasn't been something that most businesses in Uganda really have an idea about, apart from the high-end kind of businesses?
Mm-hmm. Great. So the deal for facility is a 5-year project funded by the European Union. And we've just begun our second year of operation. So our financial year ends 31st of March. So as at May, we are in the second year of operation. So we have 4 more years to go, including this year. And throughout the 4 years, we aim to support at least 400 enterprises through technical assistance and get them to the point where they're able to match with investors. Now, this is a flaw. Based on our current status and where we are, we will likely support many more than the 400 that we aim to. But the 400 is really the benchmark that we've set ourselves in terms of numbers of enterprises that we need to support over the next 4 years. So what we found in the brief time that we've been working in the market is that when it comes to capital market success stories, there's not a lot of information out there on the positive elements of, for instance, private equity. On the converse, what we see is a lot of the negative stories of private equity or foreign investment gone wrong being highlighted more than the success stories, which are actually a much larger percentage of the whole. So one of the aims of the deal flow facility is really to increase awareness on the positives of alternative sources of funding. And as such, and as one of our outcomes, we have knowledge sharing and knowledge management outputs that we actually ensure that we have ways of disseminating this information to enterprises. Case in point is that the deal flow facility has developed a curriculum on basics of capital raising in Uganda. Now therein we address questions like what kind of capital is available, who are the main investors in Uganda, how does a business position itself to actually raise capital, what are investors looking for, in terms of tax, how does a company ensure that it achieves 100% tax compliance, because all these elements actually contribute to making a business successful when it comes to raising capital. Case in point is we recently had a masterclass where we sat down with the Uganda Revenue Authority to have a session on educating businesses on what taxes were applicable to them at various stages of growth. So this is one of the delivery mechanisms that we have for this curriculum, and we're making it as interactive and as relevant as possible for Ugandan enterprises.
All right, Nora, as we wind up this interview, I want to ask you a general question that almost everyone asks. Do you think the biggest problem for Ugandan businesses is lack of finance?
I think that lack of finance is one of the biggest issues. However, there are underlying causes to this lack of finance. Based on the work of the deal flow facility, one of the things that we are seeing as a major hindrance to businesses leading to a lack of finance is actually corporate governance and structural challenges. So we're seeing a lot of businesses who have a significantly large size still being very informal. And what this means is that a lot of them, for instance, are family-owned businesses who lack the corporate governance structures needed to actually professionalize and attract alternative sources of capital. For example, you will find enterprises that do not have a board structure or have a very informal board structure where only one shareholder is actually the key decision maker. Now, this is not corporate governance best practice as far as international standards go, and this is one of the key hindrances that we are seeing to actually accessing finance. Another issue that we are seeing is around the operations of the business. When it comes to financial records, a lot of these businesses that have quite a large size still do not have formalized ways of managing their accounting and their audit. So without having these in place, despite it being a really solid business that could attract capital, then this becomes a hindrance to them raising capital. Thank you, Simon.
Surely such a facility can be a game changer for anyone looking for financing, but also for training on how to run a business smoothly. Thank you for watching The Business Show. We are taking a quick break, but don't go away. There is still so much more to come.
It wasn't possible until I just partnered with my landlady and I was like, yeah, can I have my things here? And she was like, yeah, as long as I'm going to use the Sukuma.